Hi, I'm Nick from Australiannativebee. Today I've got a special video of our trip we took up to Cairns. I hope you all enjoy it. Hannah and I were up at the crack of dawn to head up to Cairns. We had high hopes of being up there early, but were met with a storm at the airport, delaying us an hour. We were met with warm Cairns air and Karen, who was to be our guide. So we're up here in Cairns and Karen's going to show us her native bees that she keeps here. So have a look at them. Karen keeps four types of bees and hopes to collect all the northern species. Her Tetragonula carbonaria were much the same as ours, only smaller. She had simiae, which had a massive brood ball. She keeps Tetragonula clypearis and Tetragonula hawkingseye right next to each other. I couldn't help but have a look in the clypearis hive. Living in a garden right next to these two hives is a Tetragonula sapiens. These bees are very shy, often not sending many workers to conceal their position. Tetragonula clypearis live in houses all over Cairns. You don't have to look very far to find them in walls. We checked out Karen's beautiful greenhouse full of rainforest plants and ferns. We decided to head into the centre of Cairns and check out the shops. These trees were full of two different types of flying foxes. We're here in the middle of Cairns and above us, making noise.
That shit crazy.
It stinks. Smells like some sort of off cheese. Cairns is full of gift shops containing Australiana.
Nice. So if it's amplifying everything, we'll do rhythms. Sounds woo!
As the sun goes down, all the bats come out to fly over Cairns' main city. So do all the people. The next day it was time to head up to Cooktown through Mareeba, where we would meet Lewis. If you've never been to Cooktown, it's worth going up. Standing on the lookout, you will have 360 degree views all the way around. On the way into Lewis's house, we stopped to see a great bowerbird nest. This particular one had two entrances at the back, which is unusual.
You're late, Lewis.
It's
really dark. Look at him.
He's not happy.
He's very
Lewis,
happy.
Lewis, you were supposed to be home an hour ago. Where have you been?
What's its name, Edith, is it?
Oh. Actually, that's his mother.
Lewis's property is out in the middle of nowhere. There is no phone reception and no electricity. His grandfather owned it and operated a tin mine here. There is a ton of interesting history surrounding the property, and a lot of it still remains in artifacts left all over the farm. Lewis himself is a naturalist and keeps an array of animals and wildlife all over his farm. He has discovered many new flora and fauna and helped scientists all over the world with their studies. Lewis took us straight out to show us his bees that he keeps in boxes all around his farm.
He wants to have a personal... Oops, pulled up a few.
You did mine yesterday, all the bees for
me. Yeah, but they turned out. I reckon the queens of these are a bit more hairy looking. What have we got here?
Clypearis.
Clypearis.
Look at that shoot.
I asked Lewis about entrance tunnels and why some of them were so long. He explained green tree ants are the cause.
When they hang around the entrance, they keep making it longer.
Clypearis are a very small bee, but a very voracious bee. They swarm into any small cavity they can find and build a nest relatively quickly. Lewis took us to a few logs that had been left with nests in them after cutting firewood. It was here we got our first look at how determined these green tree ants are at invading native beehives. They are a very patient ant. They will wait till a bee misses the hole and quickly latch onto it. All bees up here, apart from Tetragonula carbonaria and Tetragonula Hocking's eye, will build a sticky entrance tube to prevent the ants from going in their hive. Lewis explains the length of the entrance tube is to do with how long the hive has been under attack by the ants. Green tree ants build tiny nests on the trail back to their main nest. The nest is held together with silk from the baby larva ant.
Look at them reaching out.
If you've got a little scratcher in anywhere,
that's where you feel them.
He's Lewis.
He's quite a ray.
Cincta are one of Australia's rarest bees. Lewis has known about them since he was a very little boy. Lewis only knows of 14 hives in the wild of this species of bee. This one was rescued from a large log that was being cut for firewood.
Fast though.
For such a small bee, Lewis says these are one of the best at defending themselves. Their striking yellow lines and quick flight patterns make them magical to watch.
So does this happen every year from this old box?
Yep. It's a hopping dye.
So that's interesting. Richie, edible amounts of brood in there.
I'll tell you what, they're building fast because they only put a couple of little bits of honey in there.
So if you didn't think native bees made any noise, listen to this.
Up in the morning, Lewis's property, going to have a look at some bees. Lewis took us to the edge of the tin mine that his grandfather dug. It was here he found many colonies of sapiens when he was a kid. I asked Lewis if he could take us and show us what tin actually looked like. Down in the tin mine that Lewis's grandfather dug. Pretty massive hole in the ground for some blokes to dig with a shovel.
Piece I've seen. Dad got a 90-pound lump one time when we were kids, so it was about that big and you could hardly lift it. There's the tin.
It These green tree ants were perched waiting to grab bees out of the air.
Where the thymi eye is over there. Lewis and Hannah. Sort of see the size of this area.
One of the distinct differences I noticed with Tetragonula clypearis is several lines located on their thorax. Carbonaria, Hocking's eye, and sapiens do not have these.
On the way out, Lewis and Charlie, his brother, decided to show us a few hives. Overall, it was a pretty great trip.
The road out of Cooktown has the most beautiful rainforest all around it. We decided to take a short trip to Cape Tribulation and check it out. I'm sitting at the table just next to one of the beaches here at Cape Tribulation, and down here, if you can see it, got some stingless bees nesting in the post here, which is quite cool to see. So close to the sea, going in and out. It was time to head home, and would you believe it, we had a storm on the way back into Brisbane as well.